eSure is a birth control is a women's health disaster. See the story at drugsafetynews.com.
Republicans in Congress have taken their privatization crusade to an entirely new level this week, as Republicans on the House Transportation Committee have introduced a bill that would privatize the entire air traffic control industry. As of right now, that industry is regulated by the FAA, and those people are officially government employees. Now, this bill to privatize air traffic control, aside from being insanely stupid, was started way back in the 1980s when Ronald Reagan came along and busted up the air traffic controllers unions. If he could have privatized it back then, he absolutely would have. But after he broke those unions, it broke a lot of the power that the air traffic controllers do have. Now, here's why this is such a horrible idea, and even Delta Airlines is against it. We have corporations in this country who continuously, repeatedly, almost on a daily basis, are breaking the law. Not once are any of these people seeing the inside of a jail cell. Instead, what happens is that when they make a mistake, knowingly make a mistake, and they kill people, or they poison people, or they destroy the environment, they get slapped with a fine. Usually that fine is written off in their taxes, so there really is no comeuppance. These industries are already dangerously underregulated. So just imagine what could happen when you have private company employees trying to direct airplane traffic. What happens when something goes wrong? What happens when government inspections don't come in to make sure that things are happening properly? What happens when the government says, you know what, why don't you self-regulate? One of the last times we saw something like that happen was the Deepwater Horizon disaster in the Gulf of Mexico from BP, where we allowed them to self-regulate. We did not go in and check. We did not make sure they were following procedures, and we ended up with almost a dozen people dead and an entire ecosystem destroyed. Now, air traffic, a little more intense than that, because one plane crash, one miscommunication, one private employee not following protocol is going to be an absolute disaster. Not necessarily saying that with the government running it, it's a perfect system. Perhaps there are problems, but at least the government is accountable. Corporations in America today have absolutely no accountability, but that is what the Republicans want. And the Republicans are saying that we have to do this because, oh, we're not sure about the budget. It's so hard to get anything done in Washington that we can't ensure that we're going to be able to pay air traffic controllers in the next few years because of budget battles. That is just part of the Republican plan for America, though. They consistently on the campaign trail tell us how horrible government is. Not that it's just bad right now, but that the entity in and of itself, government, what makes the United States, is a bad idea. And yet for some reason, we elect these people to something that they hate, allegedly. So they get into government and they make it work poorly. They don't allow it to do its job. And that only gives them credence to say that government doesn't work. It is a self-fulfilling, self-repeating cycle that idiot Republican voters keep buying into. And that's what they're trying to do with the air traffic controllers. Republicans have screwed it up so much, and now they can say, look how bad it is. Let's ship it over to private industry where we have no regulation and no accountability.